Read for us. Read for everybody. Surah 33, verse 37.
Why does the Bible say that a Christian father can son his daughter?
Oh!
Why?
Allah said to Muhammad. Allah said to Muhammad, he is comparing human with Allah. He is comparing human with Allah.
Are you Hindu?
He is comparing human with Allah.
Are you Hindu?
So Allah is the one who is telling Muhammad, you can get married because you have seen your daughter-in-law naked. You have seen your daughter-in-law naked.
Allah is Hindu.
How can Allah be a true God? When he is encouraging Muhammad,
you need a doctor.
You need Jesus. You need Jesus Christ.
What Jesus are you?
Jesus Christ. You need Jesus Christ, our living God.
Our
living God.
Not the Allah of the Quran.
Don't worship the Allah of the Quran. Allah is encouraging. Allah is encouraging Muhammad, you can get married to your daughter-in-law because you have seen her naked. You have seen her naked. Hadith is very clear. Not one only, but four different hadith. Sahih Bukhari. You can read Sahih Bukhari, volume 1, 2, 3, 4. Volume 1, 2, 3, 4. It says that Allah is telling Muhammad that you can get married to your daughter-in-law because you have seen her naked.
What about Genesis chapter 19, verse 13?
It doesn't make any
sense. Father is sleeping on his daughter. What about that?
No. So you are comparing Allah with the human.
You are comparing Allah with the human. How can you justify that?
You are comparing Allah with the human.
You know, Abraham, his wife was his own sister according to the Bible.
You are comparing
one father, different mother.
You are comparing Allah with human.
No, you are comparing Allah with human.
How can you compare? Human can make mistakes. When Allah is encouraging Muhammad that you have seen a naked daughter-in-law, you can go and get married.
I'm telling you, brother, Allah is encouraging Muhammad. But what about that one? The father is sleeping with daughter-in-law. I tell you another story. You are comparing Allah with human. God with his two angels visited Abraham. When God visited Abraham with his two angels, he gave good news to Sarah that you will have a child. Sarah listened and giggled. How can I have a baby? I'm so old. And God said, you laugh. She said, no, I didn't laugh. He said, no, you laugh.
You are comparing.
And I will give you a baby next year.
You are comparing your Allah.
I will give you a baby next year. God did the same. God visited Sarah and committed with her and coming to thee, and she given a birth to a child. You are making God as a human, not Muslim. Your story is God. Your Bible has 10 different stories of incest. Your Bible has 10 different stories of incest. Allah is encouraging. But you are comparing Allah with human. You are comparing Allah with human. Jesus says, listen, they listen not. See, they see not, neither they understand.
Human
understanding what I'm trying to tell you.
Human always make mistake.
Allah is not the one who can talk about these stories because your Bible is full of these stories.
Allah is the one who is encouraging Muhammad.
No.
Surah 33, verse 37.
Yeah, what is
Surah 33, verse 37. It says that Muhammad has seen his daughter-in-law naked. Therefore, Allah is encouraging
but
Muhammad.
But Muhammad didn't have any son. How he can have a daughter-in-law?
Adopted son.
Stupid, my friend.
Adopted son. Adopted son.
He didn't have a son. How he can have a daughter-in-law?
Zaid.
A brainwash, my friend.
Zaid.
How he can have a daughter-in-law when he doesn't have a son?
Zaid.
Muhammad doesn't have a son.
Zaid.
Exactly.
Zaid. Zaid.
A profile.
What's his full name? What's his full name? What's his full name, Zaid? You are quoting Zaid. What's his full name?
Ibn Muhammad.
No.
Zaid
no.
Ibn Muhammad.
No, it is not
Zaid Ibn Muhammad.
By not his son.
Oh.
Liar.
Adopted
not
son. Adopted son.
Zaid is not his son.
Adopted son.
Zaid. Not his son.
Zaid, brother, listen.
Not his son.
Listen, one by one.
He doesn't know
one by one.
That's
one by one. Judah, the father of Jewish race. Right? Judah, the father of Jewish race, saw his daughter-in-law. No. Now listen to me.
You are comparing human. You are comparing human with Allah.
I am telling you.
That's why I'm saying.
Listen to this, brother.
How can we believe you're Allah?
No, listen.
How can we believe you're Allah?
Judah, the father of the Jewish race, see his daughter-in-law sitting by the roadside, and he said to that lady, "Let me come into thee." And she said, "What you will give me?" And he said, "I'll give you a little cup." And he said, "What guarantee you give me?" He said, "I'll give you the ring." Fair enough.
When
he committed and he had two children of incest, Faris and Zara. These two children were the great grandfather of Jesus Christ.
You are still comparing Allah with human. You are still comparing Allah with human. You are still comparing Allah with human. So Allah is the one who encouraged Muhammad to get married to a daughter-in-law.
Aisha.
Not Aisha. Zainab.
Zainab. Have you wedded?
Zainab.
Have you wedded in the
book? Oh, yes.
Yes.
Many times.
Many times.
If you want to read Sahih Bukhari. Sahih Muslim.
Are you a Muslim?
Huh?
Are you a Muslim?
You can read Sahih Muslim. Sahih Bukhari. You can read this story. How can that Allah be a true Allah? Who is encouraging Muhammad to go and get married? Because you have seen a naked woman, a naked daughter.
I talk about Buddha.
Huh?
Buddhism.
No.
You used to worship a cow. You don't have a religion.
I'm talking about Somalian Allah.
Learn first the Bible,
I'm
then come to us.
Somalian
you used to worship a cow in India.
Somalian Allah.
And he converted to Islam.
I'm talking about Somalian Allah.
From cow to man.
I'm talking about Somalian Allah. I'm talking about Somalian Allah.
Listen, train.
Allah is for all.
Somalian
Allah. Allah for you.
The Somalian Allah who was a pirate.
No, you went too far, man.
Somalians are the pirate.
This is
they
not
are
religion,
still
man.
Pirate.
Okay. This is not
they are
religion.
Still pirate.
This is religion.
Yeah.
This is not religion.
They are still pirate. And he has come to steal from England.
No. This is bad. You can't shut up about him.
No, this is bad. I like to steal, but you beg. You go to the church to...
They are pirate. They are pirates from the beginning. Till now.
What do you want to believe? What do you believe and what do you want to believe?
Two God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. No, you don't. You just say with the lips.
I can say the same to you.
What?
That you believe in the wrong God, and you just like you're telling me that I believe in a wrong God.
How you justify it? How do I justify it?
Because that your God is right God.
Because that God who is talking from Genesis to Revelation, that your salvation will lie in a atonement of the sacrifice. Therefore, from Genesis to Revelation, the atonement sacrifice is there. So if nobody is believing on the atonement, he is not believing the true God. He is not believing the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Can I respond?
Yeah.
In the Bible, Jesus says, "My blood is the salvation." My blood is the salvation. Jesus teaches this to his disciples.
Yeah.
Which quote? Quote the verse. Quote the verse. Not Timothy, not Corinthian, not the Paul, but Jesus himself. right? I don't want to see Corinthians because it's the letters of Paul. Timothy is the book written by Paul. Paul never see Jesus in his lifetime, right? And I want you to show me from Bible, Jesus say himself, not ambiguous. This is not Jesus, this is the Old Testament.
No,
this is the Old Testament.
Just a minute. Leviticus chapter 17 verse 11. The blood that makes atonement.
Okay.
Okay? This is confirmed that blood.